in the hole.
Continuing in February, the 2006 PGA Tour's West Coast Swing season presented by Allianz tees off. Don't miss any of golf's greats, Tiger, Phil, Vijay, and the rest of the pack. From Hawaii to Cali, it's on USA. Next, defending champion Phil Mickelson heads back to the desert, thirsty for his third victory at the FBR Open. Starts next, live.
Your golf is on USA.
$2,500 dogs, only one best in show. The Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show, presented by Pedigree, begins Monday, February 13th at 8, live only on USA. Characters welcome.
Big John Daly, after a bogey at the second hole, in a spot of trouble at the par 5 third. Out of trouble, in the hole, birdie for John Daly. Game on. Here in the Arizona desert. Stay with us here on USA.
In association with the PGA Tour, proudly presents the first round of the FBR Open, part of the West Coast Swing, presented by Allianz.
And for the 68th year, the PGA Tour comes streaming into the Valley of the Sun. And, of course, so do the fans by the hundreds of thousands here. Record crowds certainly wouldn't surprise anybody. They're expecting more than 500,000 again this year, and today they're greeted by, well, what else? Brilliant sunshine and some brilliant golf as well here at the TPC of Scottsdale at the opening round of the FBR Open on USA. And here is a look at our opening leaderboard brought to you by Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours. And it's 45-year-old Steve Lowry setting the pace with a 65 this morning. Lowry, a two-time winner who hasn't won in close to 6 years out here. 41-year-old Jerry Smith, who happens to play out of the TPC of Scottsdale. Back on tour now. He shot a 66. Bo Van Pelt right there as well, looking for his first win on the PGA Tour. And look at those scores. It's been a while for Paul Stankowski. He shot 67. Jeff Sluman is right in the chase with a 68. Trevor Immelman, we'll see him today. He's through six holes at 3 under. Defending champ, two-time winner here, Phil Mickelson, opened with a 69. 2 under. As we take you out to the 15th, Bill Patrick with Jim Gallagher Jr., and here is Sergio Garcia.
We'll move a little bit. Very reachable par 5. Good putt there.
15, 552 yards, and playing into the what breeze we have out there today. And welcome everybody as USA brings you continuing coverage of the PGA Tour. Bill Patrick with Jim Gallagher here in Scottsdale, and so many storylines to follow this week, but let's start with this field because it is pretty special.
Well, it's got 5 of the top 10 world ranking players here. You've got Vijay Singh opened up with 71, defending champ Phil Mickelson opened with 69. Sergio Garcia had an 8th place finish last week. Chris DeMarco off a win a couple weeks ago, and David Thomas won at the Sony. And the funny thing, or not the funny, interesting thing, is 12 of the 19 past champions have all won majors, so a really solid field as they always do here in Phoenix.
It's going to be fun to watch for the next couple of days for sure. Let's talk about the finishing stretch here in Scottsdale, because if you're in contention on Sunday, you have to feel like in the final four holes especially, you've got to make some birdies out here.
Well, you do. The 15th is very reachable. It's an exciting hole. You can see some eagles there. The 16th, it doesn't have to say anything about it. It's a very exciting hole. The players are thinking about that hole before they get there. 17's a drivable par four. You'll see some eagles. And the 18th's a challenging finishing hole, and they're all playing fairly easy today. And I think you're just going to see some excitement. You can't hold back. You have to stay aggressive, and a lot of things can change, especially when the weekend comes on.
Now, of course, part of that excitement involves the fans, and they're out here in record numbers. And that is always a big part of the story here at the TPC of Scottsdale. And joining us today and tomorrow, it's a home game for Gary McCord and Peter Osterhaus as well, and Jim Nelford. Three guys who call Scottsdale their home. Let's check in with Gary.
16th hole. Usually kind of nothing when you play this during the year. Just sets there at 165-yard par three. Nothing around it, just desert. And all of a sudden, the stands erupt. People everywhere on this hole. And back there, we're going to have the Spaniard Sergio Garcia after that nice birdie there on 15. Thursday's round, usually the boys aren't too raucous back here. A lot of oohs and ahs, that's about it. And as we get towards the weekend, it will get more and more energetic. There's kind of just a murmur right now. Sergio's got it right in the middle. This hole cut in the back left. Bunker on the left. You don't want to go there. If you go over, it goes down a hill. If you go right over, it goes way down a hill. So that's going to be the safe shot today. Just plug it right in the middle and try to putt from the middle back there to that corner. This is actually just about the best pin they've got, and they're using it here on Thursday. Greg Perks now.
You know, Gary, it's always interesting listening to the players. They think about this hole and getting booed if they do hit a bad shot. It's in the back of their mind, almost like 17 at TPC in Sawgrass.
Yeah, we'd always start off here. Jimmy, you get playing it, and, you know, about the fourth or fifth hole, you hear something going on, especially on Friday and Saturday, and then it just kind of build, and then you're going, oh no, if I get there, I can't, oh man, don't hoist one in the bunker or something, I'm gonna get canned. And it does, it definitely plays with your brain a little bit. Let's go see Steve Flesh on 14.
And a tough par four, 477 yards. Very, very difficult last year in strong winds. And a very good shot, pin tight on the left-hand side. Little dog leg right to left. So a challenge for the left-hander Flesh. Bunker on the right-hand side of the fairway to the left as we look down. Let's go back to 16.
Yeah, we're going to find Wes Short Jr. getting ready to launch one. Ooh, yeah. We'll get him going here a little bit. That's about 15 feet away. This hole started off as kind of a nothing little hole, but the real reason was there was a TGIF Fridays behind this tee, and there was beer back there, and that's how this whole thing got started. Now let's go see Davis Love.
Davis Love playing alongside Steve Flesh and Stephen Ames. Just 5 yards to the left of this hole position today. And Davis leaning as if he'd hit it left, right over the flag. Beautiful shot. Chance for a birdie. It's just a challenge to reach the screen in two with any club last year. Vicious winds, cold and windy. Different story this week. Forecast to be 78 to 80 degrees on Saturday. And the crowds are extraordinary. And there we go. To 17. A short par four. After the unique 16th hole with the gallery there, it's a very interesting 17th hole. Drivable, but a very tricky green. And this will be a challenge. In the cut on the right. Very little room to the right of that cup. And look at back left, that's always a challenge. Only 21 to the cup today. 275 to carry that little pot bunker. The bunker that sticks up there in the middle of the fairway.
Peter, Chad Campbell's the only guy to knock it on the green. Most of the guys are taking a shot at it, though, today.
Yeah, they can't resist. It's quite a wide green, 30 yards wide. But if you are aggressive, there is water down the left-hand side and just enough rough to help JL there. And now I'll have a relatively easy pitch with lots of green to work with. And he's giving it the extra look there just to be sure that nobody's signaling, sorry, you're in the water. Now let's catch up with the always exciting John Daly. Jim Nelford is with the Daly Group.
And he is even par and in the right rough. Not a good lie. 161 to a right pin. And it came out of there fairly well, going towards the middle of the green. Good play. Kind of a tricky little pin over on the right-hand side of the green with a mound protecting it just in front. So anything towards the middle or towards the back is a good shot.
Pretty good result, getting the distance absolutely right and a realistic chance for a birdie. John Daly, always exciting. Started off a good first round last week at the Buick Invitational. Not so good after that. Back to 16.
And we're going to have Sergio give it a prod here from about 40 feet, 35 feet, I guess. Not the kind you make. You just want to get around the hole if you're lucky. Might go in and whoa. That's what you don't want to do. Leave yourself a thrill seeker. It's going to be from about 5 feet away.
So we are deep into the first round of the FBR Open. They're all chasing Steve Lowry right now with that opening 65. And now we're going to check in with Fran Charles at the World Golf Hall of Fame. Fran.
ING presents PGA Tour Today.
All right, Bill, thank you very much. Welcome inside the USA Studios. This is ING Presents PGA Tour Today. Chris DeMarco decided to change his routine in 2006. For the first time in his career, DeMarco made his season debut on the European Tour, and it paid off, winning the Abu Dhabi Championship nearly 2 weeks ago, his first win in 4 years. And now stateside, DeMarco looking to end his drought on the PGA Tour at the site of his last victory. DeMarco owns 3 PGA Tour wins, his third coming at the TPC of Scottsdale in 02. As a matter of fact, the 8th-ranked player in the world has 3 top 3 finishes at the FBR Open in the last 5 years, including 04 when he finished second after going into the final round with the lead. And that's just one of the many close calls DeMarco has on his resume. He's finished second 11 times in his career. These are some of the tournaments where he's either owned the lead heading into the final round and hasn't been able to close it out, or put himself in position to win on Sunday, but ultimately couldn't secure victory. DeMarco is hoping the win overseas will be the catalyst.
Hopefully, you know, going into this year, you know, getting that win off my back, it's going to help. And, you know, I hope to get in there a couple times this year. And you know, I want to solidify myself for that Ryder Cup team.
So far, Chris is even through 5. We'll have more on DeMarco's win on the European Tour later in the telecast. And speaking of the European Tour, an elite field as well, including Tiger, the Big Easy, and Retief Goosen. They're all in the Middle East for the Dubai Desert Classic. It's at Emirates Golf Club. Tiger playing with his good friend Darren Clark. Tiger, a little mojo working early. This is his chip, his third at the par 5 third. After hitting his second shot over the green, Tiger was 4-under through 4. Settled down after that, opens up with a 567. Darren Clark, chipping to get it close. How about get it in? Clark with a 468. He's 4 shots back. Defending champ Ernie Els for par at 6. Els was 4-under through 10, finished up with a 68. Retief Goosen on fire today, a bogey-free 8-under 64, 6 birdies and an eagle. Goosen, part of a 3-way tie for the lead. The Goose already has 1 victory on the 2006 European schedule, taking the South African Airways Open. This is the 3rd time Tiger's playing this event. In 2001, he lost by a shot to Thomas Bjorn. And in 04, he finished 5 strokes behind good buddy Mark O'Meara. Back in Scottsdale, 6-under is a number to beat in the early going at the FBR Open. Bill and Jim are back with much more opening round coverage at the FBR Open after the break.
You go beyond washer fluid to heated washer fluid. Beyond heated seats to heated and cooled seats. You even go beyond Lexus to an available Northstar V8. The ES330 doesn't offer a V8 at any price. Introducing the all-new Lucerne. Starting under 26,000. Buick, beyond precision, not beyond your reach.
Thank you. Retirement, as we know it, will soon be retired. How do we know? We're Allianz Life. The best at next.
The FBR Open on USA is brought to you by Friedman Billings Ramsey, capital for your conquest. By GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. And by American Airlines, we know why you fly. We're American Airlines.
We're back at the 14th hole. Steve Flesh, chance for the birdie. Right in the heart. It'll disguise what he's really thinking. Settle for a par. After a bit of a struggle last season for Flesh on the Colonial Tournament in 04, and I'm sure expected a great deal last season. Earlier at 16.
We're going to find Wes Short Jr. this earlier, and he just tickles the left edge and just beat the heck out of your putter. I hit mine so hard once, got a bone bruise right in the bottom of your hand. Nelly, you ever done that? Right in the fatty part of your hand on the bottom of it? And I couldn't grip the club for like a month. So I quit doing that. Sergio now, this first two putt. Another little sword fight with it as he tries to straighten out his putter. A little sloppy 75 the last round last week. He was in contention, ready to give it a go. And let's go see Davis Love at 14.
And this was a moment ago. A little bit downhill. Looked as if he thought that might turn, but he made the return. And we go to 15.
And here he is on the tee. And, Jimmy, we were talking about Davis earlier. You're kind of surprised he hasn't done better out here through the years.
Really have. He's had one good finish out here. He's plenty long. It gets to be a putting contest, and you've got to take advantage of the par fives. He's got plenty of length. He should be able to get to this one if he gets it in the fairway in two. He's a good kick.
Davis's best finish here was fourth place, but that was back in 1988.
I think last year he struggled with consistency with his putting, but I think he's going to go on to have a good year this year.
To the sixth we go, the par four, 436 yards. Here's John Daly.
Actually, the fifth hole, middle of the green, just a lag out of position off the tee, so settles for a par. And now we're back at 17. And J.L. Lewis having escaped that... The rough close to the lake on the left-hand side. Still a chance for a birdie. Just innocent on the scorecard, 332 yards. But this hole location, you slip to the right of the green, very difficult chipping or putting up the slope if you're just short and right. Awkward angles there. So well-designed Tom Weisskopf, who loves to have short par fours.
I think that's the beauty of it, is if you do bail it out, you're going to pay a penalty for it, especially when that pin's in that back left corner where you could chip it off the green.
It's a challenge. He's, I think, the original concept of short par fours that were drivable came from St. Andrews. A number of holes around the turn there at the old course. We saw many players driving par four greens in the Open Championship last year. Now for a birdie. I'm sure he was watching that very closely. But just a par on what is usually one of the four easiest holes on the course, the three par fives and this short par four. Let's go ahead to 18.
All right, Ustia, our first look at the 18th par four, playing a bit downwind today. Here's J.J. Henry.
I'll move a little bit to his left. Good little hole location if you do miss it, just the left. Interesting chip coming back up. Like you said, downwind, playing a lot easier today.
And that was for birdie, so J.J. with a short tap in for par here. These guys teed off on the backside. J.J. playing with Jesper Parnevik and Kent Jones. Gorgeous, gorgeous afternoon. It's not too hot. Temperature in the 70s.
J.J. Henry's 87th on the money list last year. He's a guy I think can have a breakout year. It's not long before he gets in the winner's circle. Good, solid player.
Yeah, this was moments ago here at 18. Jesper from the greenside bunker.
Always a difficult long bunker shot. Nice spin.
Wow.
Jesper getting his first win here at Scottsdale.
That was back in 1998. In fact, his youngest son is named Phoenix. That's right. I wonder if he considered naming him Scottsdale.
But That'd be a little tough.
Yeah. So par for Jesper as he makes the turn in 35. Let's go back to 17.
And most of the players giving it hit with a driver. Craig Perks, past champion at the Players' Championship, has struggled a little bit since that tremendous win. And looks as if he might need some luck to just have a swing at the ball over there.
Puts a lot of pressure on himself, Peter. He works really hard on his game. He just felt like when he won that he had to kind of play a lot better, that his game had to go to the next level, and he puts a lot of heat on himself to do that, and it's been tough for him.
He's playing alongside Sergio. And Wes Short. Wes has had a very slow start to this season after winning last year. Pin high, but that's going to be one of those challenging chip shots. All kinds of choices. .332 on the card, .321 to the cup. Every now and then, the rules officials move the markers up to the next tee and just make it almost mandatory to go for the green in two. It's a bit of a problem with the flow of play. The group in front usually, once they've got on the green, they step aside, let the following group hit up.
That and the fact that the people on 16 might boo you if you lay up.
That could happen. Definitely could happen here. They expect only the best from these players. Sergio. He was holding the finish for a moment. Well, that's not so bad. I don't know whether he thought he was going to find the water. Still only Chad Campbell having found this putting surface from the tee. Back to 16.
And we're going to find Jason Bone down here, about the same place Sergio was. Let's see if he can get a little closer. There you go. Jason Bone, one under par. Let's go to number six.
And we'll check in with David Toms for the first time today, trying to get to two under.
Winner in Sony, got off to a good start. Always a good, solid putter. Took the little hole location today. Two under for the day.
So far, so good. As we go back to the par 5, 15th now. There's a good look at it.
We actually to take the fairway and moved it back towards the tee to make it a little bit more accessible. It was a pretty long carry, and in the past, if we got wind in our face, they couldn't play the back part of this tee, so they did make the fairway a little bit bigger, just for a little more flexibility and setup, and made a few changes from last year. Not too many, though. This fairway is like 38, 40 yards wide, so plenty of room.
Here's Steve Flesch from 256.
Bring it in from the left side. It might kind of feed off. Hole location kind of on the right side, just below the slope.
There's a wonderful shot from Flesch.
Good chance for Eagle.
Wow.
Made Eagle at 13.
Steve Flesch, two-time winner on tour. Missed the cut last week at La Jolla. But did well here last year when he tied for fourth. So he likes this course.
He sure does. Mm-hmm.
Flesch playing alongside Davis Love and Stephen Ames.
Stephen Ames, winner of the Western in 2004, only finished 83rd on the money list last year. Comes off the slope a little bit. Another reasonable good shot. Not a very difficult putt.
You see a few brown spots on these greens out here, Jim, but they are in very good shape.
Yeah, the overseed didn't quite take, but they're not rolling that bad at all. They're fairly soft, so these guys can be aggressive.
And now back to the par four sixth. And Daly's second shot.
This from 106 yards, just a little L wedge after a beautiful drive.
Back to 15. Here's Davis Love.
A long iron in there, trying to bring it in from left to right. Right at it. Good shot. Come off that slope.
So the Love threesome on the green here at the par 5-15th. Back to see what they do in a moment.
Jenkins, do you know where Jenkins sits?
Sir, Jenkins doesn't actually work here.
But he's around all the time. I saw him here this morning.
Yeah, he's our software supplier.
From Chicago. Sir.
Here you go, Mr. Jenkins.
Now you can fly American for less than you think.
See you back here for Thursday's meeting?
I'll be here. Thank you.
Lower fares, fewer restrictions, every day.
I was going to give him a raise.
We know why you fly. We're American Airlines.
People who visit Geico.com could save hundreds on car insurance, yeah? Big news, yeah? But not if no one hears it, which is why I need you to help spread the word. Otherwise, our big news is nothing but a stray little fact. A wee orphan of truth wandering the streets looking for a home in someone's ear. Oh, that was easy.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
This is it, my time to shine. Getting better all the time. This is everything I wanted. This is it, this is just for me.
It targets only the gray hair. Replace it with subtle tones for a natural look in 5 easy minutes.
This is everything I wanted. This is just for me.
How did we improve golf's ultimate website? We turned to our experts, the players themselves. Introducing the new PGAtour.com, the only golf website that takes you inside the ropes with the game's greatest players. From course strategy and player diaries to live scoring and in-depth bios. Get connected to the game at PGAtour.com.
You, and you, and you, you're breathing my air.
An all-new Monk, tomorrow at 10, only on USA. Characters welcome.
Don't forget, you can follow Mickelson, Singh, Duval, Daly, and the rest of the field all week for free. PGAtour.com gives you free access to the Emmy Award-winning Tour Cast. Follow every player, every hole, every shot this week from Scottsdale, PGAtour.com.
J.L. Lewis, hole location on the front left, needs to keep it right of the pin because just 4 steps to the left, it'll fall off into a front, false front. Wonderful shot.
Let's go back to number 6 now. Here's Jonathan Bird, second.
That's after an enormous drive, 17 yards past Daly.
That's such a big guy. He sure hits it a long way. That's a nice draw out there.
to 17.
Sergio, 310 yards on his tee shot, 70 feet on this chip and run across the green. Oh, nicely played. He's had an up and down round. Only two pars in seven holes. A couple of birdies, three bogeys. Looking to get back to even par. Back to number six.
And back to John Daly for birdie.
Straight up the hill, doesn't have much in it.
Lost its speed. Went, well, the pets go to the valley towards the city of Phoenix.
Daly making his second start of the year. He tied for 63rd last week at the Buick Invitational. There's a good look at the sixth green. Here's Jonathan Bird to get under par.
Struggled a little bit last year with a hip injury.
He just had 89 yards left for his second shot after he just murdered a drive. Beautiful wedge.
Well, you know, Nelly, even if you just do it once in a lifetime, you could tell your grandkids you outdrove John Daly.
He's already done it a couple times today, yeah. So it's going to be interesting.
Back to 15 we go. Stephen Ames, Steve Flesch, Davis Love.
He's about 30 feet on a move, a little bit from his left to right. Not really too concerned with the speed.
Let's see if there's an eagle in this threesome. We'll go to 17 quickly first.
Sergio trying to get back to even par. Just a little bit right to left, nicely done. Of course, trying to fight back after a 75 last round last week.
So far on 15, zero eagles today.
Only nine guys make it on this green, going for it in two out of the 20, and all three of these guys knocked it on. So a little bit of wind maybe about an hour and a half ago made it a little bit tougher for some of the guys to get there in two.
So a short birdie putt coming up for Ames. And the other two fellows will line up their eagle putts as we head back to 18. And J.L. Lewis looking for birdie, looking to get to two under as he is about to make the turn.
And a 49th finish at the Buick last week.
Look at those skies. Aerial coverage for today's FBR Open, courtesy of the Outback Steakhouse Airship. The Bloomin' Onion One. Look for the Bloomin' Onion at USA telecasts throughout the year. Now here's JL for birdie.
Snuck it in the left corner. Well, it usually breaks just a little bit left. Just had enough dye in it to go in.
JL opens with 34. Heads to the front side. Now for eagle, Davis Love at 15.
Rolled some putts down this slope to this kind of hole location yesterday. Didn't see a lot in it. He thought that was going to go a little bit left. There wasn't much break in that one.
17.
A record holder here at the TPC of Scottsdale, Mark Calcavecchia. And he usually gives it a rip. Davis Love did tap in for his birdie. And Mark watching this closely. Useful little bounce there. Now he can see the ball clearly, get some control on the pitch. And always fun here. We saw a drive from Craig Perks. He was unplayable off to the right, so a lot can happen. Now the 2002 champion, not a winner on tour since then. Chris DeMarco. Very pleased with that win in Abu Dhabi on the European Tour a couple of weeks ago.
Peter said he worked out a lot in the offseason starting last fall, and it feels like he's gained 5 or 10 yards off the tee.
That's always going to help.
So is this the year that Chris DeMarco finally breaks through once again? As we mentioned, it's been 4 years. A new look, DeMarco with more on Chris. Here is Fran Charles.
this scorching hot Chrysler 300.
It's time to dial in your driver. TaylorMade's movable weight technology. You choose the configuration. You lock in more distance. You get the most out of your swing. The new R7 425. More movable weight. More club head size. More shaft technology. Even more distance. Dial in your game.
My boss was a jerk. His boss was an even bigger jerk. Turns out I was working for a company of jerks. So I started my own consulting firm. Couldn't ask for a better boss.
With Assurant Health, you don't have to be part of a group to get health insurance. We've been covering independent spirits for more than 110 years.
Being a musician means not always getting a steady paycheck. Sometimes you have to fill in the gaps. Health benefits? I don't think so.
Call Assurant Health now at 1-800-717-1526. And we'll work with you to find a plan that suits your lifestyle.
I was a victim of downsizing. Me, family. But if it hadn't happened, I would never have opened up the store.
If you need health insurance, call Assurant Health at 1-800-717-1526 and see how beautifully our plans can work with yours.
Welcome back to PGA Tour Today. It's all about the team for Chris DeMarco. The former Florida Gator puts just as much emphasis on making the Presidents and Ryder Cup teams as he does on winning a regular stroke play event. And that was never more evident than last September in Virginia when DeMarco's final putt of the day gave the U.S. sole possession of the Presidents Cup. As expected, the 06 Ryder Cup is on his radar, as well as a victory on the PGA Tour. 4 years ago, the last time he tasted victory on the PGA Tour. In 2005, he created one of the most memorable moments of the year.
And it's Chris DeMarco who wins the President's Cup.
12 days ago, Chris DeMarco walked into the winner's circle again, capturing a winning moment at the Abu Dhabi Golf Championship.
To get back in, coming down the stretch, no matter where you are, you're feeling the pressure, and to be able to come through, made a great birdie on 16 to give myself a two-shot lead. It was awesome.
It's a continuing cycle for DeMarco after an exciting 2005 season. He posted a career-best seventh-place finish on the PGA Tour money list to qualify for his sixth consecutive tour championship, reserved for the top 30. He also holds the symbolic title of hero for his winning putt at the President's Cup, leading the U.S. team to victory.
How I did it at the President's Cup, coming down the stretch, really helped. I drew from that, and it was nice. I didn't get ahead of myself. I slowed down, and it was just fun. Winning is fun. You know, going into this year, you know, getting that win off my back, it's going to help. I hope to get in there a couple times this year.
Chris DeMarco summing up his pitch shot here, but he might have to wait for fellow competitor Jason Bone, who drove in the lake to the left side of this par 4. And we'll catch up with DeMarco in a minute. Back to 16.
170 yards. Flag is flickering about. No particular wind direction, just kind of going all over the place. That's Davis Love holding that pose nicely. Looking up and down. Where is it? They're getting excited. Ooh. No wonder he's looking up and down. Well, it gave a gentle nudge to the flag stick as it went by. And now earlier, and this is Steve Flesh. Remember, he had that beautiful looking metal wood in here. This for an eagle. Gotta get some furniture or something for that. Don't you, an eagle on 15? This will get you excited a little bit. Okay, let's get my bearings. The top of the screen, there's the 18th hole up there. Let's go to 17 now.
And DeMarco's second shot. Trying to zip it in there and just carries it too far. Plenty of spin, but not the short birdie putt he would have liked. Very awkward, that raised up green. close calls. Runner-up finishes since his win here at the FBR Open. Last year, runner-up to Tiger at the Bridgestone. Runner-up to Tiger at the Masters. What a chip shot by Tiger. And then the eventual birdie to win. Match play, David Toms played brilliantly to beat him. So he's played some fine golf and just not managed to pull off the win on the U.S. Tour, that is, 218.
And Sergio Garcia's second shot.
Trying to get set again. I'm quite ready to hit that. That's from 137 yards. Should be just a real easy 90. Almost could get the wedge back there. So like I said earlier, needs to keep it just to the right of the hole. Gets too much spin going left, it'll fall off the green.
Sergio off to a good, solid start this year. Seventh at the Mercedes Championships. He tied for eighth last week. Yeah, very nicely done here at 18.
And he kind of fights with his consistency in his putting.
Back to 16.
And this was earlier now. Remember, he made the eagle, so now we'll take the 8-iron and see if we can just get greedy here. Try to get one close, go eagle birdie. That's what I'm thinking. Hold on, yeah, it's kind of a... It's got the rear end of this green kind of folds away from the player and starts to go down that hill. That's why it's a tough pin placement. Hard to get the ball close here. Let's go to 17.
DeMarco, still a chance for a birdie. Wouldn't have been happy with the pitch shot. But that's a nice birdie. Beautiful putt. And I'm sure he's gained confidence from that win. Even though it wasn't on the PGA Tour, any win counts. Moves to one under par. Five off the lead held by Steve Lowry. Shot his 65 this morning.
And it is time now for Expedia.com's Destinations, brought to you by Expedia.com. Enjoy your trip. Today's destination is the Phoenix area. We are in the Sonoran Desert, Maricopa County, where Scottsdale and Phoenix are located. Phoenix, of course, the capital city. And this area basks in sunshine 85% of the time. That's the highest percentage of any major American city. Phoenix, Arizona. This week's Expedia.com destination.
This isn't the job for a pencil or even a ballpoint pen. No, for this, you need a half-inch wide stripe of permanent red ink, visible as far away as the mailroom and smellable to anyone within a 20-foot radius. It's your blatant declaration that one less day stands between you and that umbrella drink. We know you love travel. And we'll help you do it right with your personal trip guide email to cover every important last-minute detail. Expedia.com.
Design impacts performance. Performance returns the favor. The six-speed, 298-horsepower G35. Behold the shape of performance. Infinity. A line has been drawn.
The Big Game Gear Up is on now. Make a play for the perfect home theater system. Get no interest till 2009, and just in time for the big game, all home theater is on sale. The Big Game Gear Up is on now at Best Buy.
Pebble Beach is back on USA with showbiz and golf's biggest stars. The AT&T Pebble Beach National Pro-Am starts next Thursday, live at 3 on USA. Characters welcome.
Over 2,000 dogs compete for the title of Best in Show, Jim, at the Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show. My money's on the Corgi, the Welsh Corgi, again this year. Monday, February 13th, 8 p.m. Eastern, only on USA. Now back to the 18th we go. Sergio Garcia, we saw his approach to this point, so this for birdie, make the turn at one under.
Talked earlier about the inconsistency, 159th in putting this year. Last year, 196th, though, really struggles with it. Being consistent, although at Wachovia, in a couple, first two or three days, he putted just outstanding. Might try to go a little to the left. Just lost its speed.
And there is the story of Sergio Garcia.
That was a good makeable putt, but that is a story. I think he really struggles with his shorter putts than anything. He's out of the top 125, actually, in the three straight years, so.
So even par 36 for Sergio as he makes the turn, heads to the front side to 16.
This was earlier. We're going to go ahead and just take the putter. We've only got about 2 feet of fringe there. Shouldn't do much to it. That's Steve Flesh. Okay, saddle three. Saddle three. Good on you. Good on you, mate. Okay, let's go live now after that great-looking shot. Are you going to get it in? Cruised across the hole on the right-hand side. That's Davis Love. Beautiful-looking 8-iron just right by the flag. I don't know if he's cruising or not. Jim Gallagher, what do you think? Last year, not much going on. This year, what do you think? What do you see for him this year?
I think he's fired to come back out. I think, you know, he hasn't won in quite a while. And, you know, I think the fire's still burning in there. I think the big thing, he's just got to get his putter to be more consistent. Even though you're in your 40s, I still think he wants to win. And that's why he's been such a great champion over the years.
Let's go to 17.
Mark Calcavecchia. A short putt for a birdie. Aggressive tee shot. Pretty good chip. Thank you very much. 3 under, cruising on nicely with the leader only at 6 under. Over to number 7.
Seventh hole, 224 yards, par 3. See that bunker on the left? That's about where the pin is, just to the right of it, way back in the corner. They're on and they're on. JD? Yeah, sets that long right in there nicely, huh? I'm going to give that 10 to 12 feet. See if John Daly can make that rare two here on the seventh hole. Stay tuned.
Retirement, as we know it, will soon be retired. How do we know? We're Allianz Life, the best at next.
Solid off the tee, you need to swing at a pace you can't control and catch the ball right in the middle of the club face.
You want to hit it a little bit longer, try moving it up in your stance just a little.
You got to complete your backswing.
Try a little pause at the top.
Try a bigger shoulder tap.
Grip it more in the fingers and less in the palm.
If you want to hit it big, you got to swing big.
And the most important tip of all,
trust your tight list.
You can learn a lot from the world's best players.
That was a good shot, too.
I've never had an eagle.
Heck, I've never had a birdie.
I would not recognize Jesper Parnevik.
I've never played a round of golf.
But I support the first tee.
It's teaching my daughter important values.
It gets them off the couch.
He's more patient, focused,
self-confident.
He's just a happier kid.
At the First Tee, we teach kids important values they can take with them from the golf course to their communities and to the rest of their lives.
I didn't know a little golf ball could make such a big difference.
The First Tee. Call today to find out how you can help.
Here's a reminder to enter the Pebble Beach Dream Vacation presented by Avis. Log on to pebblebeach.usanetwork.com today for your chance to win the ultimate golf vacation. And now back to 18 we go, and from the right rough, here's Kalkovecchia's second.
128, should be just a wedge. Looks like a decent live ball, a little above his feet. Make it go a little left. Spin on that, needs to slow down.
Stop. Right there. Thank you. Kalkovecchia, three-time winner of this event.
Nine top tens.
He won in three different decades. Only man ever to do that, Jim.
There's hope for us 40-year-olds.
Well, some 40-year-olds. Let's go to 17.
And the delicate chip shot. Coming across the green for Ian Leggett, a Canadian who lives here in Scottsdale, who's been battling some serious injuries. Carpal tunnel syndrome in a wrist. So he's been on a lengthy medical extension and trying to fight back. Let's go back over to number seven.
And we've got, among others, John Daly right there. I was talking to John. And there is another Scottsdale resident. We got them all over the place. Jonathan Kay. Five birdies last week in the last five holes. Dipped him in some serious money. I'll find him out. He practices here all the time in the back of the range hitting balls. Doesn't play much.
This from about 45 feet will break to his left. Got the claw going, Gary.
Yeah, whatever works. Ooh.
Pretty darn good stroke there.
He's all uptight, isn't he? He's a beauty. Absolute beauty. This kid's got a pretty good game, Nelly, doesn't he? It looks like he does everything really well.
Yeah, he is. Jonathan Kay, a lot of times, a lot of people have said he looks a lot like Ben Hogan, very precise and everything. He's so strong. I mean, it kind of reminds me of Spider-Man. He's got that spidey strength. Just hits it 9 miles for a little guy.
Spidey strength?
Spidey strength.
Is that a word?
Look it up. I think it is.
I know. You made up a word. Can't get it by me. But I got the picture. I got the picture. It's a good word, picture.
Same kind of putt.
Same kind of mistake. Of course, from that distance, those aren't mistakes. Look like we're going to get a little pull from downtown Phoenix there to the left a little bit towards the valley. It'd break towards the water out here, but we haven't had any for so long. Well over 100 days without any rain whatsoever, so it's quite dusty and everything out here. Solid three there for Jonathan Bird. Good name to have for a golfer, isn't it, Bird? Better than Bogey.
Daly just hit a gorgeous shot in here. He is really fun to watch swing the club. He is in such beautiful balance and rhythm all the time. I just never see anybody who makes it look any easier. This is just a right edge putt. Maybe just a little outside.
He's going left.
Yeah, made it.
Got it. Talking about two right there. John Daly gets in the red figures at one under par. Let's try 17.
Steve Flesh. A draw for most players. Power fade for lefty. And just a little right edge of the green and try and miss the water. Well, that didn't happen. No problem. Plenty of power. He would have been on the green and have been hit straight. Now taking a drop and hoping to make a par. Now Davis Love always with the power to reach short par fours.
Doesn't look to be a driver either. Looks to be a three-wood, isn't it?
Is that amazing? Can't believe he thinks he can reach the green with a three-wood. Over 300 yards to the front edge. And he will have a difficult chip shot. So if he might have even caught the rough on the right. That'd be quite something if he really thought he could find that green with a three-wood. 218.
I agree.
And Kalk to get to four under. Quite a start. Oh, killed it.
Takes the breakout, and that's a little inconsistency on the, like you said, the brown, so that's a good way to stroke it.
Five birdies, one bogey on his opening nine. Kalk in the chase, two back.
This year, when Tiger wins, he loses his ride. Because when Tiger wins a tournament this year, someone wins his tournament car. A 2006 Buick Lucerne.
If I win, you could win. How hard is that?
Go to Buick.com for your chance to win.
Wanna play?
So that's the last slide, right?
Right. So I'm hitting send?
Yeah. Wait, who's presenting in Chicago?
McLean.
McLean?
Yeah, he can do it. Right?
We know why you fly. We're American Airlines. And when you fly American, get our lowest fares at AA.com, guaranteed.
Experience some turbulence and then explode.
Six rebels on the run.
I think we better go.
A fugitive with a secret.
I'm taking your sister under my protection here.
An empire that wants her dead.
Every minute you keep her from me, more people will die.
They're coming.
Catch a ride.
Or we could talk more.
With the crew of Serenity. Now playing on pay-per-view.
Court of Slim can help me with this, then it's worth my while.
Hey, you can do this. Since I've started taking Court of Slim, I've lost about 22 pounds. I went down about four sizes. I'm more energetic, feeling like I can get up and do a lot more. I'm getting more involved with the kids, and Court of Slim has made a difference in the energy, stress, and I'm really happy with Court of Slim and the results. And I think Court of Slim's awesome.
I'm excited to get this program underway.
Hey, don't forget, we're right back here tomorrow afternoon here on USA. Live two-hour coverage begins at 4 p.m. Eastern. Don't forget, Phil Mickelson and Vijay Singh are paired together. We'll see them tomorrow. Tune in tonight. CBS brings you the late-night show tonight and tomorrow night with Mr. Faraday, Mr. McCord, and full coverage this weekend beginning at 3 o'clock Eastern time. We go back to Mr. McCord now.
And we're going to find ourselves high on the 16th hole. This wind today is just kind of coming downwind a little bit. Ooh, yeah, excellent shot right there. DJ Trahan cozies it up there. There's the 18th tee. You're standing on the 18th tee. Just try to drive it over that water, hook it a little bit. Tough driving hole. These guys, the exception of Mark Calcavecchia, already in this morning. Conditions perfect. Jerry Smith just got in the tournament a couple of days ago. He was first alternate. J.J. Henry down there, 3 under. Scores are pretty good this afternoon. Weather is supposed to be fantastic for the rest of the week. So there's not going to be too many excitement on the golf course as far as wind or anything. The guys should go pretty low. And let's go to number one.
And Sergio Garcia from just off the green, it looks like, here for birdie.
Swing a little from right to left. 40 feet, 45 feet coming up the slope. A little bit into the green. Those players just lay up off the tee with 3 wood or 2 iron. Big swing off on the left.
So that one's not dead yet for Sergio here at number one, the par four, as we go back to 17.
And the challenge for Davis Love. Little downhill lie, out of the short rough, upslope the last 30 feet or so before he reaches the putting surface. Very tricky.
Peter, out of the rough, you can kind of play a little bit lower shot, maybe bounce it into the bank. Looks like he's was going to try to do, play it in the back of your stance.
Doesn't really have a lot of choice. I mean, it's not as if he can throw it up in the air. He's just got to try and judge the line, make good contact, and then hope for the right first bounce.
And it could kick hard to the right with that little mound there just to the left of the pin.
Fine line between a successful shot and leaving it at the bottom of the hill. Chance for a birdie. Still surprised he didn't hit a driver. See, the water is very much in play down the left-hand side. Big putting surface, but well-defined hole location areas. Steve Flesch still negotiating his drop out of the hazard. Something else going on there, calling an official for that drop. And Stephen Ames, third member of this group, not waiting for Flesch. Ames just made a mess of the previous hole, but this is a beautiful chip. Double bogey at the short par 3, 16th for Ames. Winner of the Western Open a couple of years ago. Top 10 on the money list, not so good last season. 2004 was tremendous. Back to number one.
And let's see if Sergio can clean up here for par. He can and does. So Sergio through 10 holes even. And back to 17.
And Steve Flesch. There, bite. He knew he didn't have the spin. So that remaining for a par at a 332-yard hole. Muttering to himself, uh-oh. John Daly at the eighth. 470-yard par four, dogleg right to left, awkward green complex. Well, he's got a clean lie. That's a good start. And it is his second shot, so no unplayable lie to get to this area.
Yards. He has a clear shot, and the ball sitting fairly decently.
That was an interesting follow
through. A little bit chunky. Actually had a better lie than that and what you could have really expected there, Peter. Kind of had to go down and get it a little bit and caught it a little bit thick.
And a long, long way to go for his third shot. The pin back right. He's on the front left corner. Let's have a look at this. I don't think we've seen John Daly make some amazing swings and some amazing shots. Watch this follow through. It's not quite... one I've seen before. Trying to hit, I think, a little low draw around the trees. He's miles down here. The hole's 470. Pins at the back. He still has less than 150 yards to go.
Watch that right foot.
That's... What was he going to... If he missed it with the club, he was going to kick it with
it
his
out.
Right foot.
Exactly.
And hope we weren't watching. No. That was very interesting. Slippery on the sand. Back to 17. Davis Love having to wait for his birdie try. Flesh for a par. That's the danger of attacking this 17th. If players feel obliged to attack. Easiest hole on the course, averaging less than 3.5 strokes. So they know they should attack, but go left and you're in the water hazard. Bogey for Flesh. Only the sixth bogey of the day on this hole. Still 2 under par, so not so bad. And he's an emotional player. He's disguising it well. He hates having made bogey here. Now Davis. Steady season last year for Davis. No win. Couple of second place finishes. One at Harbour Town where he's won, what's he won, 4 times there? Unbelievable record. On Hilton Head. He was second at the Booz Allen in Washington. No win. Plenty of wins in his career. Would like to get back on track. That's for a birdie. Nicely done. A little out of position off the tee. Second shot was okay, but he makes the putt. Only 3 off the lead. And at number 8, John Daly for a birdie.
If you can call that 90 feet long. Looks like it's got to go.
Now, John Daly, interesting season last year. Twice a runner-up, lost in playoffs to Vijay and Tiger Woods. Vijay in Houston, Tiger at Harding Park in the Amex Championship. So it's relatively good money-wise, but John, he likes to win. He's not going well. He'll move on to the next tournament. And beaten by two big-name players. Back to 16.
Second-year pro, DJ Trahan. Yeah, there we go. Shot in there, gotta get it. DJ. 1 under par. And now back on the tee. Very quiet in there today. Look at that arena right there. That's a lot of fun Saturday when they come in there. Oh, my goodness. Look at Jimmy Walker, Henrik Bjørnstad, John Mills.
Got to be an eye-opener for these three.
Yeah, a lot of these guys have never really experienced this, so this is not really the full go of Jimmy Walker up here first. You hear about it, though, out on the tour. I think last week, and the conversation gets around. Are you guys going to Phoenix? Yeah. How about the 16th? Yeah, you ever been there? No. Oh, just wait. Paul Arnold and the Scottsdale Police Force are hanging around down here. Just in case. The boys will be serenading these guys on come Friday and Saturday. They find their alma mater's fight song and we'll serenade them all the way up.
It's always exciting. Group.
Very creative. And they'll find things about you you really don't want anybody to know. But
or you didn't even know about yourself.
No, you didn't. And they'll go right along with it. It's good stuff. Let's go to 1.
All right, Gary. And for yet another birdie, here's Calcavecchia. Pulling within 1 shot of the lead. Well, we already know this guy can go low.
He said there were going to be some low scores. I guess he knew something
What was it, back in 2001, where he set all those records?
Absolutely.
Back to 16, Gary.
Club du jour here is probably a 8-iron, maybe a 7. Dornstad is pretty long, so he might be an 8-iron in there. Should hit a 7-iron. Henry playing along there pretty well. He's a couple under par. Let's go see John Daly.
With his par attempt.
This from about 14 feet. Should break about 4 or 5 inches to his right.
Well, disappointing bogey. His tee shot was wild, but he had a surprisingly good opportunity on his second shot. Getting the ball clear of the brush. Free swing, even though there was a tree maybe interfering. Nasty bogey. Now we're at the second hole. Sergio, only 416 yards, but an awkward par four. Can't see a great deal of the fairway off the tee, and then it's a downhill second shot.
Last year, one of the hardest holes to hit on the golf course. Only 54% of the players hit this off the tee.
And the hole cut all the way at the back. Looked to be a pretty good shot. Firm bounce, and now another awkward shot. You bash it with a putter. You lob it up on the green, pitch and run. First of all, let's go to 18.
And Davis Love.
Bunker's in the right on play. Only 280 to that bunker on the right. 300 to carry the water left. Pretty wide fairway, though. It's a big kick off the left. Good shot there. Good view coming in.
That's a big tee shot for Davis there, 3 under. Here in the opening round of the FBR Open, they're chasing Steve Lowry.
Scorching hot Chrysler 300.
Retirement, as we know it, will soon be retired. How do we know? We're Allianz Life. The best at next.
This is it, my time to shine. Get better all the time. This is everything I wanted. This is it. This is just for me.
It targets only the gray hair. Replace it with subtle tones for a natural look in 5 easy minutes.
This is everything I wanted. This is just for men.
The FBR Open on USA is brought to you by Just for Men Hair Color. Targets only the gray for a natural look. By Allianz Life. Plan your future with the company that's always looking ahead. And by Best Buy, thousands of possibilities get yours. Wow. It's a good look at the Fairmont Princess Hotel, Jimmy.
It's a beautiful hotel. Very big. Needed a map to get around the place.
I understand there's a terrific spa there. I understand that.
I've never been there either. Stayed here a couple years ago. Had a lot of fun. Staying across the fifth hole.
Let's go to number 2, I believe.
Number 2 and Sergio. That soft first bounce. That would have killed all the speed. If it hadn't taken the soft bounce, he would have been well past. So trying to save a par. Looks a little dejected. Very disappointed with that 75 last week, last round. 72, par par, he would have won the event. So many players in contention. So many had an opportunity and let it slip. To 18.
All right, Usti. And back there, Steve Flesch.
Perfect drive that from 149 yards. See how well the greens are holding. They can be real aggressive with these iron shots.
Flesch might be running a bit hot after that bogey at 17. It's Flesch, Love, and Ames. And Stephen Ames up next.
Even out to the right, going to try to bring a draw in. Should be just a 9-iron for him. Good compact swing. So the player's keeping it out to the right. If the ball does get a little bit left, four steps, falls off, falls front.
A hole high on his approach. But not terribly close.
Be a little conservative.
Mm-hmm. And now the big hitter of this threesome. Here's Davis from 116.
I don't know if he can quite get the sand wedge back there. Probably just a little bitty choked down wedge. It's a little kind of a punch shot in there. That's a little spin. Got it.
Very nicely done by Davis Love here at 18. So Davis staring at another birdie. Six under is the score to catch at the moment. They jockey for position in the open round.
Listen up. The big game gear up is on now. Make a play for the perfect home theater system. Get no interest till 2009, and just in time for the big game, all home theater is on sale. The big game gear up is on now at Best Buy.
Oi, check this, right? 3 million drivers switched to Geico last year, yeah? I'm telling you this, why? Well, because I want you to help spread the word. Bloke is that number, he's quite impressed. He's like, 3 million, that's a lot of people, why wasn't I invited? Then you're like, of course you're invited. So, he stops by Geico.com and he gets his free rate quote. Okay, sure, all right, it's not a real party, it's a website, but at least now the fella's done his homework.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Call office.
Office.
Call Erica.
Fort Wayne.
Fort Wayne. Fort Worth.
75 degrees.
72 degrees.
83.
88.6 FM.
Volume up.
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 Up. Volume down.
Chinese.
Seafood.
Mexican.
Italian.
Display map.
Zoom in.
Zoom out.
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 Of all its abilities.
Call home.
Listening may be its most impressive. The voice-activated Acura TL.
That's 13 or 14. I'd only seen that course on a computer game. Obviously, Craig was my hero, and he was dominating that tournament right from the start. I really thought it would be cool to be there one day, let alone win it. The passion, the place, the players.
This February, the 2006 Winter Olympics are on USA. Direct from Torino, Italy. It's over 100 hours of live hockey, curling, and biathlon. Plus, every day, go inside the world of figure skating with Olympic Ice, featuring breaking news and exclusive athlete interviews, and a dream come true for the fans. All Team USA hockey games are commercial-free. USA is the cable home of the U.S. Olympic team. The 2006 Olympic Winter Games, February 10th through the 26th on USA.
If you are looking for the greatest and latest in golf gear, go to PGATourShop.com. Shop for great deals on equipment, apparel, and more only at PGATourShop.com. Now to 18 once again. Here's Stephen Ames looking for birdie.
Tough putt to read. There's not a whole lot in here unless it loses its speed. And it lo- lost its speed, but that stayed pretty straight.
Second hole now.
Sergio's 11th of the day to stay at even par. He's been keeping his head more still, not peeping and disrupting the stroke. Let's go to 13.
James Driscoll now on the 13th hole. That's par 5, 595 yards. Got a couple of fairways you can choose from. Narrow one on the right, fat one on the left. Or you can just hit it over the desert that separates both of them. That's about 310, 15 yards now. James Driscoll gets to 4 under par. Let's go to 18.
All right, let's check in with Steve Flesh, trying to get to 3 under.
Should be a good read off that Stephen Ames putt.
Mm-hmm. So Flesh will tap in for par. And we check in with John Daly at the par 4 ninth. JD coming up short here when Steve Flesh did tap in for par at 18. And we go back there now. Here's Davis Love trying to pull within 2 shots of the lead.
He needs to keep this just inside the hole. We talked about his putting this year. Actually, he's moved up to 34th. Last year, 95th. So has improved that a little bit. I think it's just the consistency. Had one since 2003 at the International. Sometimes you put a little more heat on yourself to win.
Well, especially since you've done what Davis has done through the years. I mean, he's got a reputation.
Good
nicely
putt
done
there.
Good read. Davis, 7 straight years of $2 million or more in earnings, and he makes the turn at 4 under. To the second again.
And Mark Calcavecchia this time. Long putt for a birdie. Tricky one to judge coming through the fringe. Calcavecchia, a resident here in the Phoenix area. And a chance to play this course if he wishes during the off season. And work to do to save par. Up ahead at number 3.
This is a par 5. This is Joe Ogilvy. And this for birdie. He's one of the best in the business at that. So Joe Ogilvy, yet to win out here on tour, pulls within a shot here in the first round of the FBR Open.
It's always the quiet ones. They sit in the back. They never raise their hand. Then the test comes, and they've got all the answers. Introducing the all-new quiet-tuned Buick Lucerne CX. Quieter on the road than a Lexus ES330, Acura TL, or Infiniti G35. Lucerne, starting under 26,000. Buick, beyond precision, not beyond your reach.
This is the first time I can remember feeling this good about my body. I went from a size 10 to a size 4 in just 2 months.
Introducing the all-new Nutrisystem, a weight loss program so easy you'd think it was magic.
It seems like magic because it works that good.
When you order, Nutrisystem sends you 4 weeks of delicious meals. Plus, you'll get an extra week of perfectly portioned meals free.
People of all shapes and sizes have lost 20 to 100 pounds on Nutrisystem. Our secret is the glycemic index, based on an amazing discovery that separates good carbs from bad. Carbs are no longer off limits, and there's no limits to how good you'll feel.
I love chocolate, so any diet that lets me eat chocolate every day is a diet for me.
For less than $10 a day, you'll savor 4 weeks of amazing food delivered right to your door.
Nutrisystem worked for me. Trust me, it will work for you.
Order our four-week program, and we'll send you an extra 7 breakfasts, 7 lunches, 7 dinners, and 7 desserts. A full week of food absolutely free.
Hey, don't forget, coming to USA, it's the 2006 Winter Olympic Games at Torino, starting live Friday, February 10th at 6 o'clock, right here on USA. To the ninth now from off the green. John Daly with the putter.
This for birdie, going to go a little bit to his right.
And it does. Sometimes tough to judge coming out of that fringe there.
Daly quickly taps in for par here at number 9. He is out in 35. Gorgeous. Gorgeous views of the FBR Open being provided by the Outback Steakhouse, Airship, the Bloom and Onion One. Captain Thomas Whitten at the controls. Now Sergio.
Second shot, reachable par 5. Ball location on the right side. It's a big bounce, got it. A little downwind today.
Well, as Usti said, his body language tells us he's not having fun, but that should help.
Well done, Carl Kovecchio. He set many tour records here in 2001. 32 birdies when he won the event with a record score to the first tee.
Steve Flesch, and I'm going to say that's pretty good.
Just a fairway wood. Yep, short of the desert. Perfect.
Well, okay. Where's my calculator? That is bogey, eagle, par eagle, par bogey, par. Still standard 34, Jim.
Absolutely.
This was a few moments ago. Davis.
Into the fairway, 300 yards. That looks like it's going a little right. Needs to get down.
And can we see it?
Nestled down there a little bit.
Squirrely.
Rough, not too deep this week, just depending if it sits down.
Steve Lowry missed the cut at the Sony Open, missed the cut at the Hope. Tied for 70th last week. Made 4 birdies in a row today. Shot 65. Got J.J. Henry and James Driscoll and Vaughn Taylor playing this afternoon. Yep.
Watched Paul hit some balls on the range yesterday. Looked like his rhythm was good. Hadn't played in at least a year. A medical extension.
Jeff Sluman, that's nice to see. There's Phil Mickelson, defending champ. Shot 69. David Toms, half his round completed at 2 under. Harrison Fraser, when's he going to win out here?
Not too long. He's a good, solid player. He's played well out here as well.
How about Nathan Green with a top 10 finish last week? He's in the field. Nathan Green, our scoring leader this year on the PGA Tour so far.
Very impressive start for the rookie.
Andrew McGee through 13 holes at 2 under par. Proud owner of that ace at number 17, the par 4. Chris DeMarco, 1 under. Jose Maria Olazabal came close last week. Jesper Parnevik, a winner here in 98. Scott McCarron, tied for 2nd last year here. Camilo Villegas, one of those highly touted rookies. He's worth watching. He's a fun player. VJ with a 71, even par, 2-time winner out here. Sean McKeel, try to Headed back in gear, Ben Curtis as well. They don't want to be known as one-hit wonders.
No, it's a hard thing to follow up. You put a lot of pressure on yourself. Seeing Craig Perk struggle with that a little bit. A lot of expectations from yourself, and that's a lot tougher than from others sometimes.
There you see Ted Purdy. And I often wonder, Ted Purdy is a University of Arizona guy. I often wonder how the fans, especially at 16, treat those University of Arizona guys. This is ASU territory out here, isn't it?
And they're the ones that created the 16th atmosphere. I'm sure they're not real, nice.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like an Ole Miss fan going to Mississippi State.
David Duvall with a 76 today. Boy, he's had his ups and downs this year, huh? Shot a 63 at the Sony Open, a 64 at the Hope, but a 76 today. And Davis Love from the right rough. Second shot here at number one.
Nestled down just a little bit, the hole location on the right side. Got a terrible kick. It's going to be a very tough up and down. Might have to hit the bump and run shot.
So Davis out of the frying pan and into the fire here at number one. And the opening round of the FBR Open back in Scottsdale in a moment.
What moves when Wall Street moves? You do. Your family does.
The Clark family has.
And big or small, growing or consolidating.
The Foley family has.
You always seek opportunity. That is why John Hancock now provides more innovative investment products to help you reach your goals. After all, the business that matters most to us.
The Rice family open for trading today.
Is the one that matters most to you. The new John Hancock. Investments for the opportunities. Insurance for the unexpected.
All design begins with a single line. A line that challenges. A line that creates power. Or control. Or size. At Infinity, a line has been drawn.
It's time to dial in your driver. TaylorMade's movable weight technology. You choose the configuration. You lock in more distance. You get the most out of your swing. The new R7 425. More movable weight. More club head size. More shaft technology. Even more distance. Dial in your game.
Ever wish you were Bill Murray or Tiger Woods playing Pebble Beach? Enter USA's Pebble Beach Vacation Sweepstakes presented by Avis for your chance to swing like Bill and Phil for 4 days of luxury and a round of golf at Pebble Beach. Watch for PGA Tour golf on USA, including the AT&T Pebble Beach Pro-Am. Log on for more details. Your golf is on USA. Characters welcome. JB.
And welcome back on a... just a... And gorgeous doesn't describe this day.
You said a lot of days out here is gorgeous. I was out here a couple weeks ago, and it was the same weather, just gorgeous.
85% of the time, sun shines here in Phoenix. First hole, Steve Flesch.
Should be any more than just a wedge. Just an awful shot. That might need to be tougher up and down than the Davises.
No excuse for that, huh?
It wasn't very...
For Eagle, Sergio Garcia at number three.
Trying to swing down to the right just a little. Needs to get up.
There have been two eagles so far here at the par five. And Sergio will tap in for birdie.
Nine guys have knocked it on out of the 54 that have tried for it in two. Pretty amazing, 554.
This doesn't look like he's having any fun at all, does he?
Well, you're not making any putts. It isn't any fun.
Lowry with a 65 this morning. But Kalk on fire right now. Just a shot back. Davis playing well, four under. Joe Ogilvy.
You know, as the afternoon gets up, the temperature gets up, ball goes a little bit longer.
Now, some work here for Flesch at number one.
A little bump and run. Got away from him. It's hard to tell what it's going to do, if it's going to hit soft or not.
So now it'll be interesting to see how Davis plays his after watching that.
I still think it's going to be the same shot, a little bump and run. I don't think you can fly this up on the green with a sand wedge. Way too many things can go wrong there. This is a more safe play. Could putt it, but I feel like you just get a little 9-iron play in the back of your stance, similar to the shot he hit at 17. Pick yourself a spot to hit it, land it, feel the shot. You have to practice this shot a lot.
Now, if you're Davis and you just watch Flesh do that, do you say to yourself, man, he just showed me nothing, or he showed me something?
Well, he hit it too hard, so the tendency is to hit this a little easier. Unbounced it. A little bit different play.
Well, there you go. That shot's impossible.
It's going away from you. If you get inside 10 feet, you've hit a good shot. That's the beauty of this golf course, the way they mow it. If you do miss the green, it gives you some options.
All right, back at the par 5, 3, third hole. That's Mark Calcavecchia. Second shot.
Coming out of the first cut of rough. Looks like a good lie. Going to try a big cut. Hole location, as we said, on the right side. He laid it up. He caught the rough on the layup. Probably was about 250, 260 from that spot. Kind of a narrow green to go for.
And let's go to the fourth hole.
And we're going to see the tee right there. This hole, fourth hole, fun, 175 yards. Shooting right back towards the Princess Hotel. There's the Princess Hotel right there, I told you. 8-iron. He improved his golf swing.
Wow.
That just about got blimped right there. Blimped just about got that thing just flushing down the hole. Hit it so close, you don't have to putt it. And watch this. Here we are. I have no idea where the ball is there, right? You don't know where it's going to come down. All of a sudden, oh, it's going down the stack. Boom. But 4 inches to the right. Let's go back to the first hole.
All right, and here's Steve Flesh, and it's a long par putt.
Coming up the valley, slow putt. It's going to be a little bit hot after that bogey.
So another bogey on the card for Flesh. It's been just about all or nothing for him, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Two eagles on the other nine. Still early in the year, trying to get those early season jitters out.
Stephen Ames. This is for birdie.
Missed the cut last week.
So he'll stay at even.
I'm not seeing a lot of putts made today.
Ames, who missed the cut last week at La Jolla, trying to right the ship this week.
Shouldn't be too much in Davis's putt. Should be fairly straight. Because the afternoon goes on, I rolled some putts yesterday. Grass gets growing a little bit. Might get a little bumpier than they are in the morning. Still some awfully good scores.
All right, here's a great shot. See if Davis can make a long par putt here.
Let's see his practice stroke. He holds his finish. Hop just a little on him.
All right, so Love gives one back here and falls back to 3-under. Have you talked to him lately? Do you know how he's doing physically?
I haven't. I think he looks like he's healthy. Doesn't look like he's having many problems.
All right, here's Calc. Oh, the gnarly little lie there.
Came out of the dormant Bermuda and just came out fluffy. Hard to judge it out of that. Looks pretty tame, but kind of nasty sometimes.
neutral.
All right, so Cal Kavecchia will be hard-pressed to birdie this par 5, but we'll find out when we come back.
Entire life. The Chrysler Town and Country with Stow and Go seating and storage.
Listen up. The big game gear up is on now. Make a play for the perfect home theater system. Get no interest till 2009, and just in time for the big game, all home theater is on sale. The big game gear up is on now at Best Buy.
Do you love spending hours working out at the gym? If you do, the Total Gym is not for you.
But if you want one of the fastest, most effective workouts ever, then the Total Gym is for you.
For our 10th anniversary, we have an incredible deal.
You can try the Total Gym in your home for an entire month, risk-free.
We'll ship you a Total Gym at our expense. If you don't see a remarkable change, just send it back, and we'll return every penny you were charged. But if you're like most of us, once you try it, you'll never want to be without it again.
Just 1 year on the Total Gym, and I've lost 45 pounds.
So take our risk-free challenge and get the body you've always wanted. Why go to the gym when you can own one?
Call the number on your screen for our anniversary special. Try the Total Gym in your home risk-free for 60 days. We'll pay shipping and handling. Call now.
Day. Last year, Phil Mickelson ranked first in putts per round and converted 48% of his birdie opportunities here. What will it take to win this year? For complete stats and keys to victory, go to PGAtour.com. Third hole now, out of the bunker. Cal Kavecchia is fourth.
Daly make it from there earlier. Just tough to spin it.
He'll be lucky to make par here. Just one shot back here in the opening round to the fourth.
Well, after that nice looking little shot Sergio hit in there. Come on, Sergio. Same thing every time. Puts the club down with his right hand. Gets it in, left hand there on the leg. Okay, now I got it. Square it up. Put it on there. Just grip it nice and lightly. One look at the line. Yeah, always go to something. There it is right there. There's the culprit. Get out of here. Now, what if he threw that thing and the ball went in the hole? If he threw it at the ball and it went in the hole? I don't think that'd be right, would it? He would get a penalty for moving his ball. That's what would happen. Have to replace it and tap it in. Let's go to 10, John Daly. And he's going to get a two-putt par, John Daly, on the 10th hole. A little slider right par 5, or par 4. And there's big old John. And here's a kid right here that can hit farther than John Daly. Listen to me closely. He hits it farther than John Daly, this rookie on the tour. Number one in the Q school, right out of college. He could just kill it.
Bubba Watson's getting a lot of attention for long hitting, but this young man can really pound it.
It's just a 3-wood, too.
Well, he's flag high, but he's a little offline. His last three drives today, 341, 314, 338 at the 13th, 14th, and 15th holes. He's flag high here, 320 yards with a 3-wood. He led the qualifying tournament all six rounds in the 60s. 23 years old, Walker Cup player last year. And he is exciting. And he has a very experienced caddy on the bag. Long-time caddy for Tom Kite. JP didn't look fazed by leading that qualifying tournament and played well in Hawaii. We'll go over to number three.
All right, let's see if Mark Calcavecchia can save par here at the par five, and he cannot.
He just walked away before he hardly even hit it. Kicking himself right now.
So Calc will drop one here. He had been tied for second. Steve Lowry, the man of the hour at the moment, a morning 65.
Dad?
Hmm.
I need 80 bucks.
80 bucks?
Well, there's these jeans.
You have to have them.
Yeah.
Do your friends have them?
Everybody has them.
Active traders are always searching for the next great investment idea.
So who's the designer?
Gorelli.
Ameritrade Apex can help you seize the market's possibilities. Join now and get one free trade for every five trades. Plus, qualify for Apex and get $50.
Dad?
Oh.
Thanks.
Assembling a great car is not unlike assembling a great team. You find the best players for every position, train them to play together. But of course, it never hurts to go out and get yourself one ringer. The legendary North Star V8 engine. Available in the all-new Buick Lucerne. For under $30,000. Buick. Beyond precision, not beyond your reach. Championships.
It's in the hole.
These guys are good.
We're live at the PGA Tour on USS.
Catch all the amazing highlights, surprise special guests, and more incredible golf coverage than any other network. PGA Tour Sunday, live every Sunday at 11.
Your golf is on USA.
The FBR Open on USA has been brought to you by Club Glove, used by more touring pros than any other product in golf. By Expedia, enjoy your trip. And by Friedman Billings Ramsey, capital for your conquest. Welcome back to the eighth oldest tournament on the PGA Tour, the 68th FBR Open. Mainstay on the tour as we go to the fourth.
Okay, Mark Calcavecchia. That looks like 7-iron. This looks like a 7-iron. Pin cut in the left. Mark likes to hit a cut, so that pin's kind of hiding for him. Towards the back of the green back there. We'll have a tough putt down the hill. Good breaking putt. And let's go to Davis Love.
Second shot. Downhill into this second green. We've seen the whole location well towards the back. And exactly pin high. Chance for a birdie.
We came on the air. Steve Lowry led Jerry Smith and Bo Van Pelt by a shot. And as far as that goes, nothing's changed. Calcavecchia is at 4-under, but he's just dropped a shot. We've got Alex Cheka, J.J. Henry, and James Driscoll also at 4-under. Some work to do this afternoon. Davis at -3. Henrik Bjørnstad at the top 10 last week. Got into the field this week. Don't forget, tomorrow we return to action here in Scottsdale for second round coverage. Comes your way at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. And once again, don't forget, join Gary McCord and David Faraday tonight for the late night show, 12:55 Eastern and Pacific, and full coverage of CBS this weekend, Saturday and Sunday, 3 o'clock Eastern, the FBR Open. And tremendous crowds, record-setting crowds here year after year after year. And thanks to the hosts, the Thunderbirds, for all their help. A local volunteer organization founded back in 1932. With their help, this event has raised more than $38 million for charity since they moved here, the TPC of Scottsdale, back in 1987. So we take you back to the second hole now.
Davis Love, look how narrow this back portion of the green is. Davis Love, a good chance for a birdie. Not a lot of break in this back corner. And certainly taking his time.
Peter, sometimes this thing tries to drift a little almost to the back of the green towards the valley. It's really a tough read.
Yeah, the general break of the second shot on the green is away from the tee, down towards the wash that runs alongside the third hole. Seem to have been fairly decisive. Side of the line, up over the ball quickly, but just a par. And seven holes to play. Only the one par five. There's three par fives. Par 71. All kinds of action over at 17. JB Holmes well wide of the target. He's flag high at a par four. I think we might see that a few times this year.
I don't know if those tables are in play or not.
I've got a feeling he might have been entitled to relief. There's a fence along there, alongside the lake, closing in that hospitality area. Look at this.
You go under the table.
This young man is a character. Here he is playing the trees. Many players would have all these tables and chairs moved well away from the line of the shot. Well, let's go first of all to number four.
Capovecchi with a long putt coming down the slope. Could be a little speedy. Break a little to his left. Oh, good judge there.
So Calc settles for par, and he'll remain at four under. And back to Mr. Holmes and his adventure at 17.
Well, he's got a little bit of a downhill line. He's got the whole width of the green to work with. It's 30 yards wide, but he only has maybe 10 or 12 feet beyond the pin. And beautifully judged. Great shots from the Blooming Onion one, showing just what he had to deal with there. Thank you very much. Bonding with the fans. Well done.
We can tell you Mark Calcavecchia did tap in for par, so at the moment he remains two strokes behind our leader. Steve Lowry checked in with that nifty 65 this morning, and no one has touched him. Jerry Smith, who plays here at the TPC of Scottsdale. Bo Van Pelt looking for his first victory out on tour, both with 66s. Alex Cheka turned in the best nine of the day so far with a 31. He is at four under par and also two strokes back here in the opening round of the FBR Open. Stay with us. We'll take another break in just a few seconds. And when we come back, we'll be rejoined by Fran Charles at our PGA Tour Today studio at the World Golf Hall of Fame. So stay right where you are.
This isn't the job for a pencil or even a ballpoint pen. No, for this, you need a half-inch wide stripe of permanent red ink, visible as far away as the mailroom and smellable to anyone within a 20-foot radius. It's your blatant declaration that one less day stands between you and that umbrella drink. We know you love travel, and we'll help you do it right with your personal trip guide email to cover every important last-minute detail. Expedia.
Here's the deal. When you talk about Geico.com, you want to communicate three things. Easy to use, no middleman, could save you hundreds on car insurance. Other than that, just sort of be personable, yeah? The old nice weather, innit? Cup of tea? That'd be lovely. How's your mum? Cheers. I'll stick with a small talk, mate. Theatrics might come across as a bit cheesy.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
ING presents PGA Tour Today.
Welcome back to ING presents PGA Tour Today. The biggest party on the PGA Tour underway. Over 500,000 fans will hit the grounds at the TPC of Scottsdale this week for the FBR Open. The 2002 champ Chris DeMarco, one of the stars they want to see. This for birdie at 17. DeMarco knocks it down. He's one under through 12. John Daly also in the star-studded field. This is out of the bunker at 3 for birdie. Daly even through 10. Davis Love the third, trying to jumpstart his year. This for eagle at the par 5, 15th. Lags it down there nicely, tapped in for birdie. Love is 3 under through 10. Sergio Garcia was one of the third round leaders a week ago at the Buick Invitational. This for birdie at 15. His sixth hole today, and now Garcia's tee shot at 4. His 13th hole today, starting on the back. Sergio staring it down. Why not? Missed the birdie putt. He's 1 under through 13. Mark Calcavecchia, a 3-time winner in Phoenix. And he gets the birdie to go at 17. He is 4 under through 13. Everyone on the field chasing 45-year-old Steve Lowry. He played early this morning and played well. A 6-under-65 to take the clubhouse lead. Lowry looking for his first win in 5.5 years. Calc's three wins here have come in three different decades. Brant Jove, he was a halfway leader at Torrey Pines last week, continuing to play well. A couple of two-time FBR Open winners. Phil Mickelson opened with a 2-under-69, and Vijay Singh even par 71. USA analyst Jim Gallagher Jr. joins us now from the TPC of Scottsdale. And Jim, as the week goes on, the crowds will get a bit bigger and a bit rowdier. Did you enjoy that kind of atmosphere as a player, or could it get under your skin?
It got a little under my skin because I flinched on 16 one time. And I let it really get to me. But I tell you what, you do think about it. You come in there on 13 and 14, you're going, man, I can't wait to get to 16, you know. But I remember when Tiger made the hole in one, I mean, the roar was incredible. So, I mean, it is something you should just take in as long as it doesn't get in the way, if you can concentrate. But it is, I'll tell you, it's not. There's nothing like it on the PGA Tour.
We'll see Vijay Singh and Phil Mickelson tomorrow. Moderate starts for both. But as long as they're playing, they have to be considered threats.
Oh, absolutely, and I think they're going to feed off each other and they're going to challenge each other. I think anytime those guys of that caliber go at each other, it's going to be a fun day tomorrow. And there's